Hey guys, it's Kelly, welcome back. In today's video, I wanted to share with you guys what my makeup collection might look like if I did not have a YouTube channel. So I saw Zabrina film a video like this recently and I wanted to share my own version of it with you guys because oftentimes when we see collections on YouTube or we just talk about makeup in general on YouTube, we tend to see just one side of it. You're seeing someone who's, a lot of times, not always, but someone whose job is to film YouTube videos and to review products, and it makes sense that they have extensive collections. Not only are they purchasing it for their job to review it, but they're also receiving a lot of products in PR. And I think sometimes that can kind of twist our mindset of what a typical collection looks like. I think for everyone, we're all gonna have a different definition of what our realistic We're all gonna have a different definition of what our realistic collection would look like and what our perfect collection would look like. But in this video, I wanna highlight kind of more of what my own collection might look like if I did not have a YouTube channel. Now keep in mind, I don't have a gigantic collection. YouTube is not my job, it is my hobby. I don't receive a ton of PR. I am lucky enough to receive a few products, but most of what I have purchased. So even though I do still try to limit my collection and keep it manageable for my own lifestyle, the reality of it is that being in this space, I am more inclined to pick things up, to feature on my channel, to use on my channel. I'm often getting recommendations for other people, so it's tempting to pick things up as much as I try to be realistic. You know, I do have a larger collection right now than what I probably would have if I did not have a channel. So that's what we're gonna feature today, just kind of what it perhaps would look like if I did not have a YouTube channel. So I'm gonna go through these products in the order that I would apply them. So for primers, I started thinking, okay, if I was never on YouTube, I had a smaller, more curated collection, what would I need for primers? I think I would only need about two, maybe a few more, but I narrowed it down to two. I wanted to pick something kind of smoothing, pore filling, and then I wanted to pick the opposite, something that's a little bit more radiant and a little bit more hydrating. So for the pore filling one, I picked the e.l.f. Mineral Infused Face Primer. Before I was on YouTube, I was super into drugstore products, so I tried to reflect that in this video. And I think honestly, before YouTube, would I have a ton of high-end primers? No. Now for the more moisturizing one, I picked this guy from First Aid Beauty. It's the Coconut Skin Smoothie Priming Moisturizer. I actually received this recently from First Aid Beauty, but I feel like if I had to narrow it down, this is a good one to pick because as I've told you guys before when I reviewed this, it kind of dances between a moisturizing primer and a glowy primer. So you get the best of both worlds. And in my tiny little curated collection, this gives me a lot of bang for my buck. For foundations, before I was on YouTube, I never had more than two foundations at a time. Usually I would just have one, I would run out and I would repurchase it. I did not experiment with my foundations. I didn't feel the need to try others. It was not until I was on YouTube and I was having people ask me recommendations, comparisons, just my general thoughts on foundation. That was when I started trying more. But before my YouTube days, I could have two foundations and be set. So the two that I picked are my two favorite. Well, this one's not as much my favorite anymore, but this is the Wet n Wild Photo Focus. I'm actually panning this at the moment. This has a solid medium coverage, but you can build it up pretty full. It used to be my all-time favorite, and I'm kind of falling back in love with it. But my actual favorite is this guy right here. It's the Peach Perfect from Too Faced. And you guys, you know, I've talked about this a lot. I just find it very smoothing. They're both kind of matte, but they're not extremely matte in drying. They're kind of more of a satin finish that you can manipulate a little bit. So these are two really great ones. Now that I'm sitting here, I'm thinking, wait a minute. I would probably want a BB or CC cream too, so hold on. Okay, so I grabbed a BB cream. Well, this is actually a tinted moisturizer. This is from First Aid Beauty. It's the Ultra Repair Tinted Moisturizer. I love having the option of something very lightweight and a little lighter coverage, so I think I would actually need this in my collection as well. Okay, for concealer, that's another category that if I was not on YouTube, I don't think I would have a collection of concealers. I don't even have that many concealers right now, but before I was on YouTube, one or two maximum was plenty. When I use that up, I'll buy a new one. So I'm just putting one in my little curated collection. This is the Ulta Beauty Full Coverage Liquid Concealer. I just kind of picked this one at random because I sat there for a while. The first one that I put in the collection was my Too Faced Born This Way concealer, but I started thinking, okay, before I was on YouTube, I was so into drugstore concealers. I really did not move into high-end concealers until after I got onto YouTube, so I don't realistically think I would have bought this if I didn't have a YouTube channel. So I put this one in because it is drugstore, but my favorite drugstore concealer before I started my channel was the NYX HD, but I don't have that right now, so we'll just pretend that's what this is. Now, another product I know I would have because I had this before I started my YouTube channel, this is the Anastasia Beverly Hills Contour Kit. I'm sure this is a product I would still be using very consistently. I didn't even grab a powder because I'm like, you know what? I have powders from in here and I'm not a huge powder person. I'm trying to think, before I started my channel, well, did I use a lot of powders? I used the NYX powder, but that one gave me flashbacks. So I just didn't even pull the powder, and I'm like, you know what? I'd probably get by on these two until I ran out, and then I'd probably just buy a refill if I didn't have a channel. Here's my thoughts on contour kits. If you have a large collection, you're probably not gonna reach for this that much, and that's how I feel about my contour kits. I'm oftentimes just reaching for the individual products in them. I'm saying contour kits, but this could also include a blush kit, just a face palette in general. But if you have a smaller collection, these are a lot of bang for your buck because you have everything you need right in one. So that's why I threw it into my small non-YouTuber curated collection. For bronzer, I sat there and I was like, would I have multiple bronzers? I don't think I would have. I love using bronzer, but I'm not even a, that's not a product I collect. So I grabbed my butter bronzer. I think this would probably be the only bronzer that I had. It would pair nicely with the bronzers in the contour kit. I could use those interchangeably, so this is the only bronzer I put in. With highlighters, I want to say that these were the two that I had before I started my channel. I could be wrong, but I'm pretty sure these were the two that I had, and I don't really see myself needing too many more. This is the Mary Luminizer by The Balm. It's got huge pan in it. This is a total favorite of mine. And then the highlighter that I'm wearing today on my cheeks and a little bit on my eyes is the shade Beverly Hills from Ofra. So these are two of my favorite highlighters in general, and I think if I didn't have a channel, I don't know that I would have branched out too much past these. There was a point in time when I was like, I'll never find a highlighter that's better than the Mary Luminizer. I don't need to try any other highlighters. So if I didn't have a YouTube channel and I wasn't always getting recommendations, I wasn't testing other products out to understand their formulas, I don't know that I would have gone too far outside of my Mary Luminizer, to be completely honest. For my blush collection, I grabbed two. Now that I'm looking at these, they're kind of a similar shade. So maybe I should have grabbed something a little bit more pinky, but this is Undressed from Urban Decay, my favorite blush of all time. I'm wearing it today. I'm trying to pan it. It's an impossible product to pan, let me tell you. But the other one that I grabbed was my Too Faced Love Flush blush. This is similar in the sense that it's a peachy tone, but this one's a little bit more luminous with a tiny bit of a glow to it. So these are really the tones that I reach for the most frequently. Sometimes I use pink, so maybe I would have a more pinky blush in there, but a blush is another category that if I did not have a YouTube channel and I was not exposed to this world, I don't know that I would have a gigantic blush collection, to be completely honest. All right, the category that I think you've all been waiting for, that you're probably the most interested in, was eyeshadow palettes. And now I really thought about this, and my first round picks were a little bit different, and then I sat there and was like, okay, let's think about this. Let's kind of try to curate this a little bit better so we don't have as much repetition. Before I tell you these, I'll tell you what I had at first. First, I had Modern Renaissance. I had Naked 1, Naked 2, and Yes Please. Now, my thought process behind that was I already had Naked 2 before I started my channel, so I probably would have kept that. And I also feel like I might have eventually bought Naked 1 because I loved Naked 2 so much. And then I'm like, you know, I probably would have bought Modern Renaissance because it was so popular, as well as Yes Please. But I started thinking, okay, between all four of those palettes, there's some repetition for sure. So I tried to curate these a little bit better. So I did keep Modern Renaissance. I think even if I didn't have a channel, the hype of this would have drawn me in enough to pick it up. I do think this is somewhat versatile. You do stick more in the warm tone range, but you can do something a little bit softer as well as something pretty bold. And this is one of the many palettes I have on my eyes today, if you're wondering. But I know that even if I didn't have a channel, I was still a pretty big Anastasia fan before I started my channel, so I think I would have been drawn in with the hype to purchase Subculture. And this was another one that I wanted wanted to throw into my curated collection because it does have a lot of unique tones in there. They're a little bit more colorful. While these shades are more muted colors, it still would give me a little more versatility in my small collection. But I think I would have picked up Yes Please as well because of the hype. I know I would have fallen into it whether I had a YouTube channel or not, but I threw this in because it really fulfills my need for very bright, bold, warm tone shades, but also some more neutral tones to do more everyday looks with. And the final one, I debated for a while. I was like, would I have the Masquerade palette in my collection if I didn't have a YouTube channel? And at first I thought no, because I'm like, you know, if I wasn't exposed to YouTube, I don't know that I would be as familiar with Juvia's Place. But then I got thinking, okay, before I had a YouTube channel, I was still watching YouTube pretty consistently. I would have known about the hype with this brand, and this was a palette I wanted to throw into this curated collection because it's very versatile. You have colorful rose, but you also have very neutral rose. And this might not be my perfect collection for me right now. How do I explain this? The looks that I think I would do with my makeup if I was not on YouTube, did not have a channel, would probably be a little more toned down and muted than what I wear now. I feel like being exposed to YouTube and having a channel has pushed me to step outside my comfort zone, try some more creative looks, get a little bit more colorful. But if I did not have a YouTube channel, I don't think I would have ever done that, to be completely honest. Maybe sort of colorful, but I wouldn't be doing purple, green, pink looks like I like doing now. So this was what I picked. It was tricky though. What do you think of these? Do you feel like these four would kind of cover all the bases for me? I think they would. This video is getting long, so I'm gonna speed it up a little bit. I picked out one mascara. This is the one I'm currently using, the Volume and Length from Koki. If I didn't have a channel, and even now that I do have a channel, I do the same thing. I just have one mascara at once. That's what I try to do at least. I use it up till it's gone and then I buy a new one. So I know if I didn't have a channel, I still wouldn't be stocking up on mascaras. With eyeliner, I tried to give myself a little room for creativity with a blue liner. This is Prance from ColourPop. I have it in my waterline today. And I also had this before starting my channel, as well as this guy. This is Get Paid from ColourPop. This one is a copper tone and this is in my Project Pan. And then even though I don't wear liner too much, I did want to throw in a black one just to be safe. So this is the Sigma Longwear Eyeliner Pencil. I'm sure I would have this if I didn't have a channel, or not necessarily this exact one, but some form of a black eyeliner. But now that I'm sitting here, I didn't grab a liquid liner. So let's also throw in the Sigma Wicked Gel Liner, which is my favorite for doing winged liner. And now for lip products. I kept this very small. I don't know if realistically it would be this small if I didn't have a YouTube channel, but I tried to curate these the best that I could. So here's my thought process. I grabbed a lip liner. This is NYX Natural, my favorite, perfect for a nude lip, but you could make it work for most other shades as well. Now I probably grabbed too many nudes, but I just love nude lipsticks and lip products, so I wanted to give myself some variety. So this is e.l.f. Lip Lacquer in Natural, one of my favorites. I wanted to get a slightly deeper nude lip gloss, so this is the shade Toffee from Anastasia, another favorite. I wanted a more sheer, shiny lip gloss, so this is e.l.f. Champagne Glam. And then finally, I wanted more of a liquid lipstick type of product, and this one's a little bit more pink, not quite as light and nude. This is the shade Alyssa from ColourPop. It's an ultra satin. And then I wanted to give myself some variety for bright, bold colors, so I grabbed a bright red because I've always loved a red lipstick, even long before I started my channel. I love the look of just a bold red lip and then a neutral look on the eye. But this is the shade Missy and Fierce from Wet n Wild. And then I wanted something a little bit deeper and more vampy for the fall time, and this is the shade Rock Steady from Urban Decay. So I did swatch these all out on my hands. You could kind of see the variety that I have in my tiny little curated collection. The only thing that I might be missing is more of a bright pink. I do have the more muted pink, but maybe more of a cool toned nude shade. But overall, I feel like with all of these tones, I could live with just these colors. I might maybe want a few more, maybe even a more orangey tone, but I could make these colors work, and if I didn't have a channel, I probably would not branch too far outside of these tones right here. But that's gonna go ahead and complete this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. It was definitely a challenge for me, and even as I sit here with these products next to me, I'm thinking, It might be a little bit larger than this. I tried to really curate this and keep it as minimal as I could, but realistically, I might have a few more things, I might have a few less things, but at least this gives you a bit of a general idea of what it might look like. So if you guys enjoyed this or you found it helpful, please let me know by giving it a thumbs up, and I will see you tomorrow at 9 a.m. Eastern. Bye!